So good evening. There is some issue with this light. No problem. It has gone somewhere. So we now kept the So this is the iconic subscription we have. So it is basically a combination of the best of the Unacademy and the best of the prep ladder we'll get here. And we have a recorded sessions, video lectures, and question bank.
So it is basically the
some technical glitch in the initial part. So it's a live batch, and the subscription is about iconic batch. It is around 12 months. It will cost you around 49,000. So which will be around 4,100, but if you choose for 3 years, it will be a 82,000. So very simple to join NetBG 10. You can use, and you can use my the code for the getting the 10% discount. So it is the icon because the Unacademy plus Plup Ladder. It's a live classes, live test and quizzes, batch courses, structured schedule. And we have video lectures, question bank from the prep ladder. So I welcome you all to who joined us. Good evening, very good evening. So that's a brief about the iconic batch. Mixture of the best of the best educators. Now we start the class with the conversion disorder. And we start with this first question. To understand, after witnessing a violent argument between her parents, a young woman develops a sudden onset of blindness, does not seem to be as distraught as would be expected by this development. She reacts normally to the light, and she manages to somehow avoid the obstacles. Okay. Now the answer is C. Very good, Dr. Tapan. Conversion disorder or anybody else? Malingering, factitious, or somatization disorder. Sab log Tapan ji ka baat maan lenge. Well done, Dr. Tapan. Answer is the conversion disorder. Why conversion? So very good, Dr. Fatima, Dr. Nishal, Dr. GPD, Dr. Jat saab, aisa mat kariye. Why it is somatization? You have been so proactively learning. So now we learn a bit about it. So the whole story of psychiatry start with this topic. There is a man called Sigmund Freud, now the father of psychiatry, was happily enjoying his life as a professor of chair of the neurology. He was the professor of neurology. So the whole story of psychiatry started with the hysteria dissociative disorder and the conversion disorder. And the whole story started in 1894 when Sigmund Freud was happily enjoying his life as a professor of chair of the neurology. Okay, professor of chair of neurology, and he was the referred a case of a lady who is not able to walk for 3 years. He being professor tried to understand, everything was normal, but still lady is not able to walk. Then Freud heard something about the hypnosis. He tried hypnosis on the lady. Under the hypnosis, we know the lady recovered and she become normal. Okay. Freud then left the neurology and become the father of psychiatry by saying that this, everything is normal, but still the lady is not able to walk. There must be something super brain. Let me go in search of super brain. With this dialogue, Freud resigned from the post of neurology and become the father of psychiatry. But people ask him, he said there are three level of mind: conscious, preconscious or subconscious, and unconscious. There are three levels of mind: conscious, preconscious, and unconscious. So gradually what happens is, conscious and unconscious. He said the normally stress got converted to the conscious and ultimately it got, but if the stress keeps on coming, it will not kill me, it will keep on going to the unconscious mind. And Freud said that the moment the unconscious mind get filled up, or moment there is too much of stress, when unconscious mind stop taking the stress, the lady would have a seizure. So she will have a pseudo blindness, pseudo aphonia. Okay. So when the unconscious mind can't handle the stress, it convert the mental energy into the physical symptom. The unconscious mental energy got converted to the physical symptom, the unconscious mental stress or energy converted to the physical symptom, hence the name conversion disorder. Freud saab ne kaha, Dr. saab, kyunki the conversion name come from the given by Freud, that the unconscious mind is converted to some physical symptom. We know these people, they come to us with the in the emergency, with the, they come to us in the emergency with the dramatic symptom and refer to the junior most doctor on the duty that you all better, you treat it, slap her, pinch her, ammonia or else, whatever you want to do, but she should not be back here. They come to us with some dramatic symptom for which medical doctors don't find any cause and they refer to the junior most doctor in the intern, that it's your responsibility, check her out, do whatever, slap, pinch, ammonia or else too, but just check her out. The name hysteria has been given by the Hippocrates, who say it is because of the wandering uterus. It is because of the wandering uterus. Then in 1960s, the name has been shifted to the dissociative disorder. So whether I say hysteria, whether I say dissociative, it is one and the same thing, or conversion. So hysteria keh lijiye, dissociative keh lijiye, or conversion disorder keh lijiye, it is one and the same thing. But we must appreciate that as per DSM-5, the dissociation has been made a completely separate topic. Dissociation has been made a completely separate topic. बहुत लैग है डॉक्टर साहब. लैग मतलब मेरी वॉइस में और यहाँ लिखने में. देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ लैग. आई वाज जस्ट या. सो DSM-5 एक्चुअली रिमूव्स दिस. इन DSM-5 वी ओनली हैव द कन्वर्जन डिसऑर्डर प्लेस्ड अंडर द सोमैटिक सिम्टम somatic symptom disorder. So we have the somatic symptom disorder. ठीक है डॉक्टर. So but what, how do you identify? Because in this there is a ataxia abasia and labella indifference. What is ataxia abasia? It's a loss of function despite normal anatomy and physiology. Loss of function despite normal anatomy and physiology. That is ataxia abasia. As happened to that girl, that despite everything normal, she is not able to walk. That's ataxia abasia. Labella is a French language word meaning emotional. That means emotions are not matching with the loss. You remember that question? In that question, the lady is not as distraught as would be expected by the as distraught as. See, in malingering there will be a over emotion, but here it's a labella indifference. Somebody will say that, sir, today morning I get up and I see that I cannot see. Initially I can't see 10 kilometers, 2 kilometers, then I can't see 200 meters. Not 2 hours on, I am totally blind. So smilingly tell, that's a thoda aankh chala gaya, roshni chala gaya, andha ho gaya main to. It's a labella indifference. But you don't expect that. You expect somebody to be crying, distressed. But on the other hand, he come and tell you smilingly, kya takleef hua, kuch nahi doctor saab, I become blind. and some hemiplegia also happen, half body not working. So that's a labella indifference. But what is the benefit, Dr. Saab, of having this? There are two benefits. We have three benefits, in fact. Primary gain, secondary gain, and tertiary gain. In usual examination, we will be asked about primary and secondary. In NMANS and new assembly, we will be asked about the tertiary gain. What is the benefit? It's a relief from the unconscious anxiety. Relief from the unconscious anxiety is being called as primary gain. Some benefit I got, some extra care I got from family. So I had a seizure, father say no, sister will not do any work now. She will take complete bed rest. Remote will be in her hand. She can watch television whole day. You should not disturb. So much benefit. One seizure made me to take a complete bed rest. TV remote in my hand. Now I can watch television 24/7. It is my channel only. It's a, yeah. Some benefit is secondary gain. And tertiary gain is a gain to family. So, sometime the family also get benefit. Father is working as a driver. The owner is very strict otherwise. Don't give any leave. But when he say my daughter is ill, then he will be given the leave. So that is the one concept, that hysteria, dissociative conversion are one and the same. Now hysteria conversion are same, the dissociative has been moved to some different topic in, a totally different topic in DSM-5. Now conversion has been clubbed up with the now somatoform disorders. Somatoform is a type of disorder. We know this is basically a, all we have somatoform except the, without doubt sir. Abhi to somatoform nahi pahunche, kaise sawal puche. Galti rat sir. It is the post-traumatic stress disorder. We have hypochondriasis, conversion and the somatization disorder into it. Very good, Dr. Raj Ravi and Dr. Tapan. Jatsab, conversion is also a type of a somatoform disorder. We'll be learning. Well done, Dr. Jatsab. Now we learn what is somatoform disorder in the past. Now it is very simple. Somatoform disorder is basically patient comes to doctor with some bodily symptom for which, or somatic complaint for which, doctors don't find any signs. Figure out, sir. So previously it was like somatization disorder. And hypochondriasis. Let us focus on these two difficult ones. Rest all are immaterial. Somatization disorder is that there are multiple somatic complaints, multiple bodily symptoms, chest pain, breathing difficulty, distension abdomen, and so on for 2 years. So they must have at least 6+1 symptom. One must be from neurology, of four system for 2 years. सो मल्टीपल सिम्टम हो, चार सिस्टम इन्वॉल्व हो, एक सिस्टम न्यूरोलॉजी का जरूर होना चाहिए फॉर 2 ईयर्स. नाउ समबडी कम विद ऑल दिस कंप्लेंट्स ऑफ चेस्ट पेन, ब्रीदिंग डिफिकल्टी, डिस्टेंशन अब्डोमन, प्रॉब्लम यूरिनेशन, टिंगलिंग, हेयर पेन देयर, वीकनेस हेयर, वीकनेस देयर, सो मेनी कंप्लेंट्स ही नाउ कम टू यू एंड यू आर अ गुड डॉक्टर, जेन्युइन डॉक्टर, यू will say yes, there is no complaint, it's all normal. So what he will tell to himself, that's how I think, I know it happens, hota hai, that's how I understand, abhi naya naya padha aapne, hota hai, better discuss with your professor. So what they do is, they do doctor shopping, they have the multiple investigation. But why? To know the diagnosis. To know the diagnosis. That's a, so many complaints I am telling you. Please tell my diagnosis. But now lately, what we know, that this has been called as the somatic symptom disorder. Somatic symptom disorder. And now time was 2 years and it is only 6 months. So as per DSM-5, it has been called as the somatic symptom disorder, and for this criteria it is for 6 months. We are running a special classes where we learning the concept of the every Thursday, Saturday, Sunday, 11 to 12 p.m. So this Thursday we have the schizophrenia, Saturday we have the concept of mood disorder, and Sunday we are learning the neurobiology, neurogenetics of the psychiatric illnesses. In hypochondriasis, what happen? We know either no or minimal pathology. Is taken as a sign of a deadly disease. I think AC need to be on, this computer some problem happens. I'm sorry, doctor, sir, but it is not writing, so it is taking away the attention. No or minimal pathology is taken as a sign of a deadly disease. Okay. Sign of deadly disease. So we know one could normally hear 2-3 vowel sounds per day. Now somebody hearing 2-3 vowel sounds per day, some distension, some constipation, time is up, it's it's a carcinoma colon. That's a very better get the beriminema done, better get the CACT done. Basically, it's a carcinoma colon. So what they, and somebody had needle prick, somebody had needle prick some year back. Now he has a normal gastroenteritis. He has a fever, a diarrhea, but he is sure it is HIV. Local lab negative, Lal lab negative, medical college lab negative. Everything is negative. You tell him, gentlemen, everything is negative. He will say, that's up. It may be the window period. So what they do is, they also do doctor shopping. They have the multiple investigation. But why? To confirm the diagnosis. I know it is a carcinoma colon. I know it's a HIV. Please give dots up, confirm with the test. So in English, often we get confused in the exam between the jugglery of the words. So to overcome all the confusion, we have a simple understanding that the basic cognition of the hypochondriasis is, the thanatophobia. It's a fear of deadly disease. Thanatophobia. Fear of death. And again, we know the hypochondriasis is being called as the illness anxiety disorder. So thereby avoiding all the confusion, yes, doctor, illness anxiety disorder. I don't know what happened to the pen tab. Okay, let's do the question. Okay, again for 6 months, illness and anxiety disorder. So now the name is simple. Okay, now we have the MCQs. A 45-year-old female present with a history that headache for 6 months. She had a several consultation and all the investigations were normal. She still insists that there is something wrong in her head and she seeks another consultation. The most probable diagnosis is phobia, psychogenic headache, very good hypochondriasis, or currently being called as the illness anxiety disorder. So there is some jing involved. Illness anxiety disorder. Very good, Dr. GDP and GPD and Dr. Raj Ravi and Dr. Tapan Sharma. Sorry, Dr. Sab, for the initial slowness because of the laptop. Now, that's the question. Which understanding the hypochondriasis or illness anxiety disorder, or it is being called as the cognition is the thanatophobia. It's a fear of death. So we know it's a normal preoccupation or abnormal preoccupation with the normal bodily function. Sorry, Dr. Sir, for the poor setting. It is because the some technical glitch. But I think it serves the purpose that it's currently been called as the illness anxiety disorder. So though at the origin, the conversion and the dissociation were same, were conceptualized as same, but currently we have only three topic in the somatic symptom disorders, somatic symptom illness disorders, that is the somatic symptom disorder, that is somatization disorder, the hypochondriasis is being called as illness anxiety disorder, and the conversion disorder or the somatic neurological symptom disorder. Okay, so well done you all. So answer is the correct. Now we have been telling you it again and again that hypochondriasis in DSM-5 is called as, so we invite you to the free special class for psychiatry on schizophrenia on Thursday 11 to 12, mood disorder on Saturday, and the neurobiology, neurogenetics and everything on the Sunday 11 to 12. Now hypochondriasis is in DSM-5 is called as, अच्छा मेरे को दिख नहीं रहा डॉक्टर साहब, शायद मेरा ही लैग है. You are able to see and mark the answer. Well done Dr. Raj Ravi and Dr. Tapan. It's a illness anxiety disorder. Now a last question, PM, Dr. Sir. It is 11 PM to 12 AM. Last question, we may discuss about this in the part 2 of the dissociative disorder, but just to enjoy the class, we know it's a ए, अभी कर लेते हैं डॉक्टर साहब, ऐसा गलती करोगे तो भी हो जाएगा सवाल. शी वुड प्रिक हर फिंगर, मिक्स ब्लड इन द यूरिन. डॉक्टर राजेश नायक, वेरी गुड, इट इज सी, फैक्टिशियस डिसऑर्डर. And Dr. Tapan also very good. So please mind. So let's enjoy it here only. What is malingering? We know malingering is fakeful production of medical symptom for some gain. MI hoega, instead of jail I'll go to hospital, I'll arrange my money, I'll arrange the bail. It's a malingering. Fakefully producing the medical symptom for some gain is being called as the malingering. Very good Dr. Jitender. Factitious disorder, or what is being called as the factitious disorder by proxy, previously called as the, thoda ruk jate hain doctor sahab, previously been called as the Munchausen syndrome and Munchausen syndrome by proxy. Munchausen syndrome or Munchausen syndrome by proxy. Very good. We know it is a topic of psychiatry for which the term like doctor shopping has come into first time into literature of psychiatry. We have the hospital addiction. Professional patient. Forget about professional doctor, they are professional patient. And they tell you a false story, fantastic story, pseudo logia fantastica. In this also, there is a fakeful production of medical symptom for getting medical attention. That's my mistake, I would have typed it. So, fakeful production of the medical symptom for getting the medical attention is being called as the factitious disorder. I'm sorry for this. So, if the somebody fakefully produced the medical symptom for getting some benefit is being called as malingering, but I just produce it to enjoy the company of medical doctors, it will be called as the factitious disorder. So, with this, I thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you in the round 2 on the next Tuesday. And I'm sorry for this technical glitch, but I'll learn a lesson from it and would do all in typing. We'll enjoy everything by typing from next class. So, we know the name Munchausen has been taken away. The name, as per DSM-5, we know the Munchausen has been taken away. We now only have the factitious disorder or and factitious disorder by proxy. So, that is the latest in the DSM-5. So, we learned 3 latest thing happened in DSM-5. Factory disorder and factory disorder by proxy. The name Munchausen has been taken up. Okay, that's up. And somatization has been become the somatic illness disorder, somatic symptom disorder. Hypochondriasis has become the illness anxiety disorder. So, with this, I thank you all with the last question. And sorry for the technical glitch which happened. Last question, Dr. Sir. Munchausen syndrome by proxy involves answer is last question. Abhi thank you kar diya sab chale. I think my system is very slow. Yes. It is C dot sub. Akshara ji, it is not D. Proxy involve the only the illness caused by the caregiver. So, drug abuse nahi hota, toxin mediated disorder bhi nahi mana jayega. It's an illness caused by the caregiver. So, bahut sara log DD kar diye. So, it is the only C. It's an illness caused by the caregiver. So, somatoform pain disorder, Dr. Saab bata dijiye, aap hi ko pata hai. Somatoform pain disorder is There is pain at three sites or even one site for 6 months, for which doctors, yeah, it is used, Dr. Saab. It has been subdued under the categories. So it is not used nowadays, but it was there in the literature of somatoform disorders. So it is included under the convergent disorder as a somatic pain disorder sort of a thing. So it is one of the part and symptom of the convergent disorder nowadays. So I think that is all, Dr. Saab. Thank you so much. Good night. See you if you wish to enjoy the class on Thursday, 11 p.m. schizophrenia concept, and then we can enjoy the mood disorder on Saturday and neurobiology on the Sunday night, 11 p.m. to 12 a.m. Good night, all of you. Thank you so much for joining with us. Thank you.